Hi everyone, my name is Gus Posey. I'm the steam lead here at Wings Over the Rockies Air and Space Museum. Today I'm going to tell you about the Nakamura Paper Airplane. And my hope is that everyone has a good paper airplane in their back pocket. So today's the day maybe we can try this one for you. You may know how to fold this plane. It's a pretty common plane on Earth and something that we all fold from time to time. But I'm going to see if I can add a few tips and tricks to make it fly a little better and maybe add a little bit of the aviation science that we try to teach around here. What you're going to need today is a piece of paper. Any piece of paper like this will work. I typically use just an 8.5 by 11 sheet. You may be using something like an A4 sheet. That's pretty similar and that'll work just fine. I've also got my handy dandy Crayola marker here. This is going to be really helpful for flattening. You can also use your thumbnail or any kind of tool like that. But something for some nice sharp crisp creases will definitely help the plane fly. Now if you want to decorate, I have a little decoration down here, our logo, Wings Over the Rockies. You might notice it's down in the bottom left corner of the page. If I want to show that on the wing, I'm going to put that face down towards me to start. Now to begin, I'm going to start with the world famous hot dog bun fold right down the middle, just matching those corners at the top and the bottom, and hopefully getting a nice sharp crease right down the middle of the page. Now again, you can use your thumbnail, or again, the marker here is a great tool for getting that nice crisp crease. First step complete, delicious hot dog bun. I'll open that up. You can notice my crease here in the middle. I'll use that as a reference line. And then it's just the top edge and the corner folds onto that center line. Now you may recall we made the first step as a hot dog bun. This step, I hope you see, looks a little bit like a house. So the hot dog bun became a house. Now if we go up to the point of the triangle here, right at the top of the roof, I'm going to fold that straight down onto the center line, about an inch from the bottom, about 2.54 centimeters from the bottom of the page. Something kind of like an envelope, or for you younger viewers, maybe just Gmail. Again, I'm going to encourage you to add a nice crisp crease across the top, maybe using your flattening tool to make sure that everything's nice and flat all the way across. Now, if you have an envelope like this, you have reached the tricky step. And what we need to do is just put this down here so the envelope sort of top edge is facing me. And I'm going to take the corner and I'd like to fold the corner right to that middle line, but I need a space at the top. Believe it or not, pointy paper airplanes are not a great idea, and having a little bit of a flat surface to start is a great way to get that nose up when you're flying. So I'm going to use my thumb right next to the center line. I'm going to fold the corner until it touches right on that center line. And you might notice when I fold it, I've got a space then at the top about as big as my thumb. And again, that's about an inch or about 2.5 centimeters. The other one's easier. I can just bring the other corner right across, put it right next to there. And if the corners are touching, it'll automatically make the same space. Now, I don't know exactly what that looks like. I think it looks kind of like a sad chicken, but I'll let you make the determination on that. Once again, I'm going to grab my marker. Just make sure I've got a nice flat edge here, nice flat edge over here, and then we'll continue. I'm going to grab this triangle, fold it up over the corners. Not so far that it folds or tears the wing, but just so far as to cover those corners, get them nice and flat, and then I'll lift up the whole plane, fold it all in half with the triangle on the outside. And if you're an airplane fan, you might think that looks a little bit like the vertical stabilizer on a 747 or a 777 maybe. Now we're almost done. This is our last chance, just a little bit of symmetry here. I'll make sure everything's matching, but it's time to make the wings. On the long line of the wing, not this little short line, the long line from here to here, I'm going to pinch that and roll it over so that this line, the leading edge of the wing, is parallel with the bottom of the plane, the keel, just like a boat. Nice flat wing there. And then of course I can just flip it over and fold the other wing to match. Symmetry is important, so I'm going to try to match those corners so they're just the same. Now it's all folded, I'm going to pop those wings up a little bit. It's called dihedral. That's going to help us too. I'm going to try to make sure it looks mostly the same, but from the back it should look like the letter Y. Not like a T, definitely not like an M, but sort of like a capital Y. And when you have that capital Y, you are ready to fly. All right, everyone, hopefully you had a chance to fold your Nakamura and are ready for some test flights. I'm lucky enough to have a big hangar to fly around in. Hopefully you have a similar space. I recommend holding it right in front of the triangle here, making sure you have a little bit of that Y shape, that dihedral is important, and then just straight out like a dart. All right, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time for more tutorials.
Thanks very much for watching. You know, we've got a lot of really great artifacts in this museum, and we can hardly wait until the time comes when we can open our doors again and you can come and see them in person. Until that time, we're going to be working very hard to bring you new content, new demonstrations, new workshops, all kinds of wonderful things for you to watch on video. We're really dedicated to our mission of educating and inspiring people of all ages about the aerospace endeavors of the past, present, and future. If you like what you've been seeing, and if you want to support our museum, please follow the link below and make a donation. And thank you very much.